This is Extreme Animals, the show which brings you face to face with the wonders of the wild.
We've searched the planet to bring you 10 of the best. They're outrageous, they're awesome, they're incredible.
But using your animal instinct, can you guess exactly why they've made it into Extreme Animals? Time to face up to the tough nuts.
Introducing the Extreme Animals Top 10 Tough Guys. Take a closer look. Any look familiar? Do you know what makes them so extreme? And can you guess why these baboons are all fired up and ready for a fight?
What makes these fluffy pink flamingos hard as nails?
And why these crabs are Christmas crackered?
And what have the rest of these guys done to deserve a place in the Extreme Animals Top 10 Tough Nuts? Any ideas? Well, you better start thinking quick, because all is about to be revealed. So who's up first?
This is one cuddly teddy with a bad attitude. Mess with him and he'd rip your head off. If sheer brute force is your idea of tough, then you'll love the polar bear. Tall and weighs 700 kilos. That's the same as a small car. And he lives on one thing, meat. And that makes him the toughest carnivore on Earth. Well, can you imagine finding food in a place like this? He can walk hundreds of kilometers to find his favorite prey, ringed seals. Not easy to catch. Because the seals live out at sea, he's had to wait months until the ocean froze before even being able to get close to them. So he's literally starving, and a starving bear is one mean hunting machine. His prey is hidden deep beneath the ice. No problem for our bear. He can smell a seal from a kilometre away. That's some nose. Those huge shoulders are as powerful as a battering ram. But seals are slippery little suckers. It takes one tough bear with one tough mind to keep going against these odds. He won't give up till he's made a kill. Beluga whales may be twice his size, but they're easy meat for a polar bear because he's brave enough to take them on. And it paid off. He got his meal. Imagine the strength needed to drag that huge carcass onto the ice. Now, I call that tough.
You're telling me? Respect to the king of cool. But I've got a tough nut that's too hot to handle.
These Christmas Island crabs have a mission impossible. That's why these hard cases have earned their place in our tough lineup. Crabs with a difference. They're definitely landlubbers living in the forest. But every year, 100 million of them make an epic journey. They cross the island on foot. Well, feet. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, you say. But for a crawling crab, that's the equivalent of 10 marathons. And 1 million will be crunched on the way. Go if you think you're hard enough. That shell is his skeleton, but it's on the outside of his body. I call that a hard case. They might be armor-plated, but I'm betting the truck will come off first. Although those sharp claws can puncture tires, that's just plain shellfish. But why do this assault course? Well, these crabs are driven by biology. They've got to get to the sea to lay their eggs. And the beach assault is timed perfectly for the right phase of the moon. And then the final challenge. Releasing their eggs into the surf without getting drowned. Not a problem for a normal crab, but these guys can't breathe underwater, so each wave could drown them. That's not a wetsuit, but you could say it's a shell suit. So she survived her mission impossible. Now for the long march back to the forest. She's driven by biology, so it's no wonder she's a bit crabby.
These crabs have earned a place in extreme animals for their sheer guts, determination and stamina. You guessed that right? Next up, a monkey who really likes to chill. In minus 15 Celsius. I always thought that monkeys lived in hot countries. So what are they doing here? These are Japanese macaques. They live in the mountains of Japan where the winters are freezing. But they're snow ordinary monkeys. They've shown how toughing out the winter can be a lot more fun with some clever thinking. Winters used to be a grim affair. Often the only thing to eat was the bark off the trees, and the only way to get warm was to keep moving. These snow monkeys know how to tough it. But there's no such thing as a monkey without a cheeky side. And one winter they worked out how to cheat the freeze by having their own winter house spa, of course. Oh, are you? No bombing. That's more like it. Just relax and enjoy the steamy bath. The hot springs were built for Japanese holidaymakers. Then one day, about 40 years ago, a monkey called Mukubili decided she'd give it a go. Soon, the rest of her family were copying her. Who said monkeys can't move with the times? I wouldn't like to share my bath with the macaques, and neither did the Japanese. So they built these new baths specially for the monkeys. Lucky them. Now the macaques come here every day to warm up and chill out. You know how cold it is getting out of the bath. Well, imagine if your bath mat was ice. Not nice. But it's not as bad as it looks, because they've got a thick undercoat that doesn't get wet. It's a bit like a really hairy wetsuit. These guys are having a ball. In fact, they've turned a bad situation into fun and games. They're clever and hard. A great combination when there's nowhere else to go. Get it?
So the Japanese macaques made it into this tough lineup for being the coldest monkeys on Earth. I'm impressed. Check out this little beauty. Can you guess what it is yet? Yep, it's a koala. And boy, is she a toughie. This little lady may have one of the cutest faces around, but she's got a stomach of steel. And she needs it. The koala has one of the toughest diets on Earth. No chocolate or ice cream for this girl. Leaf it out. The outback of Australia is as dry as a wallaby's pouch. Only very tough plants can grow here. Like the eucalyptus tree, which has leaves laced with poison. Now, this is about as tasty as taking a mouthful of washing up liquid. But the koala loves eucalyptus. It's all she eats. Cool, that's disgusting. The reason she can stomach such a poisonous supper is her guts are like a cement mixer. Food tumbled round with lots of friendly bacteria breaks down the poisons. If you ate eucalyptus leaves, you would just get one very nasty tummy ache. Although, I'm not saying she doesn't get the odd antisocial side effect. Excuse me. Now, if you think she's got a tough life, it's koala babies who have it really tough. Cos they have to eat poo. Oof, that's revolting. But without it, he's stuffed. Cos this is how his mum passes on her friendly bacteria so that he'll be able to digest eucalyptus leaves as well. But however incredible her tough old stomach is, eucalyptus leaves still take hours to digest. So she passes the time between meals snoozing. She sleeps an epic 19 hours a day. It's a hard life, eh? They could sleep for Australia, which is where the koala lives. Do you know, I'm starting to see the good side of being a koala. Hey, you, wake up! Obviously, she can't bear the thought.
Now that's one tough, gutsy lady with a cast-iron stomach. Okay, halfway through. Did you guess what made these guys so extreme? Or were you surprised by the hard-headed polar bear?
The cool dude kangaroos?
The hard-nut Christmas Island crabs?
The laid-back Japanese macaques?
All those crazy koalas.
An awesome lineup, and there's plenty more to come. Keep on using your animal instinct to guess why these next five deserve a place in the Extreme Animal Top 10 Tough Nuts.
Now I've got a leggy lady who's hanging out in a lake in Africa. This is no normal lake. The water is 50 degrees Celsius and contains chemicals that would sizzle your skin. So what are these guys doing? Lake Natron is a soda lake. Not soda pop, this is soda hot. 1 million flamingos come here every year to breed. It's Flamingo a Go Go. Don't be fooled by the pink look. Flamingos are well-armed. They've got heat and chemical-resistant legs, so this is like a paddling pool to them. Okay, so why are these tough birds such a girly colour? Weirdly, it's their food that turns them pink. Tiny shrimps that they sieve out with their beaks. Wow, the flamingo must be really tough to stick their beaks in that hot soup. Okay, so these guys have got the hardware to live in this soda lake. But Lake Natron really is hotter than the Pussycat Dolls. So why come here? Well, it's the nastiness they love. The flamingos are the only animals tough enough to take it. Even hyenas wouldn't dare go there. That makes it the safest place for the flamingos to raise their chicks. But it's not all plain sailing. It takes constant care to stop their eggs being hard-boiled in the heat. Some years the acid bath gets so hot that all the baby flamingos die. So I reckon they should get out while the going's still good, or else they'll get stuck in the mud.
Wow, some birds like it hot, but I've got another who's completely chilled. Check this out. Winter's coming to Antarctica and happy feet are on the move. All the penguins are heading out to sea. It's about to get really cold. Hey, you bird brains, what are you still doing here? These emperor penguins may look mad, but they'll show you the true meaning of tough dad. Mum lays the egg and hands it over. Whoa, careful, a second on the ice would freeze it. Then she heads back to the sea for an easy winter, fishing and having fun with the girls. Wise choice, because now winter really takes hold. I think Dad got a raw deal. The Emperor could certainly do with some new clothes, like a hat and a scarf for starters. The only choice is to work together and share body heat. Shuffling round lets them take it in turns on the cosy inside. It's minus 60 degrees. You'd be an icicle in minutes out there. But not these tough nuts. To top it all, now the sun sets behind the horizon for the last time. It will be dark for a month. But these dads take it in their stride, hunker down and take on the elements. Emperor penguins really do deserve their place in extreme animals. You knew that, right? Sunrise at last, and his feet begin to feel a tickle. Hello, son. Now, what would you do if you were served this for your tea? Dad brings up some fish juice, all that's left of his last meal 3 months ago. Nice. You might call that sick. If Mum doesn't come home soon, he's in trouble. But who's this? Remember, she left him holding the baby. Do you reckon he should trust her? But hey, if you'd starved for 115 days and lost two-thirds of your body weight, what would you do? So, it's over to you, Mum. And now it's 100 miles back to the sea with the rest of the boys.
Wow, that is one tough, dedicated dad. Penguins really are the kings of chill. Whew, I need to warm up. But where is everyone? Hey, look down here. This baby is having a prickly start in life. He's a thorny devil, and he's home alone. His mum laid her eggs weeks ago, and now she's nowhere to be seen. It's a bit cold-blooded. But like all Aussies, he takes it in his stride. Nothing for it but to go it alone. This little guy earns his place in this show for a serious streak of determination. There's half a meter of sand. 10 times his body length between him and the outside world. At last, some fresh air. Although it takes one look to see he's hatched out into a real tough place, the middle of a big desert. But those spikes should scare off trouble, and this little chap has good instincts. Like all Aussies, he knows to get in the shade before he's scorched. But which way to go? There's a question. 6 months later, and our spiky speedy Gonzales has slowed down a bit. He's still looking for that shade, but why rush things? There's food everywhere. The trouble is, which one to choose? That one. Oh, that one. Oh, that one. Yeah, that one. That one. Oh, that one. Oh, that one. Yeah, that one. Thorny devils only eat ants, and they get through about 1,000 a day. Ants aren't easy pickings. They fight back with a squirt of stinging acid. Imagine if your sausages attack you. Hardly any animals are tough enough to stomach such a feisty feast. But why have all those crazy spikes? Well, they're not just to look tough. Check this out. You know it's dry in the desert, so this little devil has a groovy solution. Its spikes work like straws. The grooves in them suck up any moisture and channel it into its mouth. Extraordinary. Oh, dear.
Very good. A devilish trick from a tough nut Aussie lizard.
Now for the kind of dad you don't want to mess with. He's the head of the family, and he's in a bad mood. In fact, his whole family are pretty hacked off. But then so would you be. They're stuck 4,000 meters up a mountain in Ethiopia. But even though it looks about as safe as playing on a skyscraper, this is the safest place for the kids to hang out. Eventually, they have to go up top for their tea. And this is where the real trouble is. A band of bruisers want to muscle in and steal his family. The bachelor boys mean business. That big red heart shows Dad's boss, but they've got other ideas. only one baboon gets to be king. So the other males gang up and spend all their time trying to depose him. That's a warning. He's seriously outnumbered. But they've underestimated him. The kings are always the biggest males, with huge canine teeth. There's no denying who's the toughest around here. Now he's seen off the competition, he takes his family back to safety on the cliff edge. This is a nursery for tough nuts. Can you imagine being allowed to play over a 300 meter drop? My mom would freak. But those baboons love hanging out here. Looks like his babies are gonna grow up to be just as tough as their dad. But for the time being, not so bad tempered.
To those high-living, mean-moving gelada baboons.
Wow, that was totally extreme. We've just seen some incredible displays of sheer guts, brute force, stamina, and survival.
All these animals have earned a place in the top 10 extreme animal tough nuts. So, which was your favourite?
Was it the 3-metre-tall, 700-kilo polar bear?
The cool dude boxing kangaroo.
The hard nut Christmas Island crabs.
The chilled out Japanese macaques.
The kooky koalas with their tough tummies.
The flamingos with their acid resistant legs.
The awesome emperor penguins.
The ant guzzling drought surviving thorny devils.
The amazing freezing crickets.
And last but not least, the cliff-scaling gelada baboons.
It's tough to choose a favourite from these wonders of the wild.
They're outrageous, awesome and incredible, but most of all, they're extreme animals.